Hi everyone, I'm Emily, and today we are learning the science behind the balloon over a flame experiment. For this one, you're going to need a lighter, a candle, water, safety glasses, a couple of balloons, and because we're dealing with flames and things that are going to explode, you should have some adult supervision. The first thing you want to do is put on your safety glasses, light your candle, now blow up one of your balloons. Now, see what happens when you put the balloon over the flame.
Oh, I hate this part.
Okay. Let's talk about what happened there. We're adding heat to our latex balloon, which is exciting the molecules in the latex and making them sort of wiggle in place. The bonds between the latex molecules is becoming weaker. They want to break apart. And when that happens, we create a weak point in our balloon and that makes it go pop. Now let's see what happens when we add water to our balloon. Put that balloon with a little bit of water in it over your flame. Get closer and closer and closer, and eventually just put it right on top of your candle and the flame goes out. We have prevented that flame from getting oxygen and it completely went out. And then something cool happens right after that. The air inside the candle was originally really hot, but then the flame went out, that air cooled down, creating a relatively low pressure environment, which sucked in our balloon. Look, we can even do, ta-da! So why doesn't the balloon with water in it pop? Well, water is really cool because it has something called a high heat capacity, meaning it takes a lot of energy to heat up water. This is why it takes water so long to boil when you put it on the stove. So we're really doing the same thing that we did before. We're heating up the latex, which is making the molecules in the latex wiggle and shake, but now the water molecules are touching those latex molecules. So the latex molecules are transferring that energy to the water, and because water has a high heat capacity, it's really efficiently transferring that energy throughout the other water molecules. It's absorbing that energy really, really well. And because of that, we no longer have a weak point in our latex balloon, and the water has saved our balloon from popping. The other thing we can look at here is look at the bottom of our balloon. Look at that black stuff. What do you think that is? That's actually coming from our candle. Our candle is made out of paraffin wax, which is made up of carbon and hydrogen atoms. And when we heat up our candle through the act of combustion, we're creating light, we're creating carbon dioxide, and we also have some stuff left over. That's that black smoke you see in the flame. That's from incomplete combustion. When the flame can't find enough oxygen, it has a little carbon left over that it didn't transform into carbon dioxide, and that's the same stuff that's on the bottom of our balloon. This is soot from our candle. You can see that it just comes right off like that. This is leftover carbon from incomplete combustion. And that is the science behind the balloon over the flame experiment. Woo! Ah! So scary. You have to like, oh my gosh. You have to like, this balloon does not want to come out actually. Wow, okay. Whoop, there it goes.